One day, BBC Songs of Praise rang me up and they said, oh, we've heard about your choir. We'd like you to come and sing on our 35th birthday programme. I was like, oh, lovely. And they said, what's your name? And I was like, we don't have a name, because of course we'd always been the host choir for the gospel train. So they said, well, get a name by tomorrow. So I fell asleep that night and I dreamt of the name, the Kingdom Choir.
Lord, I've been broken, although I'm not worthy.
This went on till about 2008 and I left the country and went to America and I went to study. This version of the Kingdom Choir, let's call it phase two, we didn't do hardly any profile stuff at all. In fact, we were mostly meeting in my front room. We'd just talk and process, or we'd pray for one another. Or, you know, we built very strong connections. It was really a time of connection, loving one another, dreaming big, praying, worshipping. And I think that's where the strength of this choir, because I just wanted to nurture them, nurture, teach, pour out into them. And those are special times. And I think that's why you see this group of people who are so very celebrating of each other and so very loving, because they've been through some stuff. You know, they've had some experiences together.
My lovely daddy. Spent a lot of time, I feel, honing who we are, becoming who we are. So going from a choir that does a lot of events and gigging to becoming more of a family, that's what it feels like's happened.
It kind of felt like we were the hidden choir, and then all of a sudden we kind of came out of obscurity and, you know, onto probably the biggest platform of the century, what it feels like anyway. And I feel like those days of just being hidden and being, you know, close together actually was great preparation for what we were going to do at the wedding, because we understood and fully understand who we are.
In April, I remember I'm having a call from Karen and she said, so what are you doing on the 19th of May? And I was like, I've got no idea. Although I had a friend who had a 50th birthday, so I was like, oh, I'm going to Laya's birthday party. And there was a tone, no. So what are you doing on the 19th of May? I was like, oh, she goes, look it up. What's on the 19th of May? I was like, I was like, oh my gosh. She goes, you need to be available on the 19th of May. So she didn't really say what it was. And when I found out, it was extraordinary. We are seeing things that we don't see, getting to see people, getting to kind of share how we do life with other people. And that's amazing. That Stand By Me touched people in such a way.
What's powerful about our group is that we all have a connection with Karen. She is not afraid to be exactly who she is and say exactly what she thinks. And, you know, she's got a very clear image in her mind of what she wants. But so much of that is driven by love, not just of like love of what she does and passion for getting things right, which is a massive part of it. But she also is super passionate about all of us kind of achieving our full potential. And she always speaks about like pulling out the gold. And she's like, pulling out the gold isn't always pleasant. It's always not nice. It's not always nice. It's not always easy. But like pulling out the gold is what she's here to do. She's very good at speaking to somebody's fear. And completely kind of, it's like she's a gardener and she just goes in with a shovel and she digs that thing out, and it's like there's no space for it here. She does it with so much love, so much authority, and so much care.
To make you feel my love. When the evening
you can have a down day, a bad day, and then you walk into rehearsal even, just or even a little social, and your day has been uplifted.
So rehearsals are about the singing, and that's great, but actually it's just about being with them, really. That every time we get together. Even when people are tired, like you can see people tonight, they're really tired, but every time we get together, there's joy.
Now that we're on this journey, I'm journeying with people who have loved me, and we're really glad that we have this opportunity to you know, do what we did on the 19th of May and do that again, but you know, everyone can just have it in their homes, you know, and kind of, you know, share our message that way.
Like what you would hear on the CD is just a snippet of what was in the room when we was recording. That what is on the CD is amazing. So imagine that times 10. It's just mind-blowing.
The people who stop me down the road are all colours, they are all races, they are all classes, they are all ages. They'll talk about the inclusivity. They don't use that word. But one lady said, we felt like it was our wedding. Our wedding. Or there is a 4-year-old little girl who is the daughter of a friend of the member of the choir. And when she saw the choir on the TV, she said, look, Mummy, they look like me. And I wonder how comes that child could articulate it at 4 years old? What was she not seeing that made her say, they're like me? I didn't know it could be the catalyst for racial healing or integration. I had no clue. Dream big with people, and then you see the dreams coming true. That's so encouraging.